We last spoke pretty much towards the end of last year, and of course then we spoke again during the middle of the year. Hasn't the picture totally changed?
Yes, Vivek, I mean, I think, you know, things are certainly improving from the Indian market's point of view. I mean, whole of last year, or, you know, maybe last couple of years, actually, you know, market has been in a sort of a weakish mode. We have seen, you know, for most part of the year, you know, industrial, IIP growth has been pretty much near to the zero, you know, for the last several months. And also inflation has been our key worry for the last several months. But, you know, both of these two key macroeconomic parameters are now, you know, moving into the, you know, sort of a benign zone. IIP, you know, for the latest month has picked up quite well. And, you know, I'm sure, you know, I mean, even though it has got a base effect of last year, but, you know, certainly I think the growth from the Indian manufacturing point of view, I think, you know, we have certainly bottomed out. We have seen, you know, three quarters of GDP growing around in near 5.5, 5.3%. Now, that has also, you know, pretty much, I think, you know, bottomed out. We are not, you know, going to decelerate any more from the current levels onwards. I think on the overall macroeconomic front, and as well as even inflation also for the latest month has come down to around 7.24%. Even we have seen our RBI governor issuing, you know, sort of, you know, dovish kind of a statement for the, you know, going forward. So it's certainly, I think overall the macro environment is, you know, positioned very well for the next calendar year. We have gone through the pain periods in the last 1 to 2 years in terms of, you know, very muted growth in terms of manufacturing and earnings growth. So overall, I think certainly, you know, I mean, we are, I mean, market is positioning for a sort of a optimistic kind of a environment for the next year or so.
So you're saying that you're going into calendar year 2013 extremely bullish, is it?
Absolutely, yeah, that's true. Because, you know, I mean, most of the negative parameters, which macroeconomic issues, which have been affecting the, you know, equity markets, either in terms of earnings growth or in terms of, you know, PE multiples, you know, are, you know, actually, you know, changing for the positive for the next year, actually.
If we were to look at 2012, Sampath, we've had actually a fairly decent gain in the market, isn't it? Even if you compare just from index to index, we are up 25-odd%. So from a valuation point of view, do you see a strong upside given all the factors that you outlined even in 2013?
Right. See, actually, you know, from the calendar year perspective, the earnings look, you know, pretty good. But, you know, last year, December, we had an extremely weakish kind of a market at that point of time. But, you know, for the last financial year, if you look at it, you know, the market was actually down, you know, about 10%, you know, for the last financial year ending FY12 March. The same thing, if you were to look at in the current financial year, probably we are likely to earn about end up only about 10 to 12% kind of returns. From the point of December, the market appears to be very high. I mean, I've grown very well. So that's, you know, sort of, that's because especially the last year, December was very weak. So that's why, you know, don't take the 25% gain as, you know, sort of a big returns, and, you know, that's why the valuations have turned expensive. I don't think so that is the case. Currently, you know, even if you look at the earnings estimates as well, you know, for the next year, on about 12 to 14% kind of an earnings growth estimate, market is trading only about in about 14 times or so, which is, in fact, if you look at in the long range PE multiple, which is more of a stable PE multiple, you know, in the long range, you know, PE multiples were as high as 22 and as low as 9-10, but in a more static kind of a PE range for India, if you look at it, it's been generally in the between, you know, 13 to 17 times kind of a range. So it is pretty much 14 times, you know, with a very low earnings growth expectation, about only about 12 to 14%. I think, you know, market is, you know, pretty much positioned very well for the bullish thing for the next financial year as well as next calendar year.
And are you in the same camp as many other experts, Sampath, who believe that this year we could take out our all-time highs and go even beyond that?
Yeah, I certainly think so. I mean, this year, you know, I mean, about, you know, from now onwards, I think, you know, 50 market is positioned for this year as well as next year, you know, we could certainly see about 15% kind of a growth returns in the market, whether, you know, that will be bunched up, you know, in the first year itself, or, you know, I mean, it will be spread over, you know, both 2 years, you know, I mean, it's difficult to say, but certainly I think this year, I mean, the next financial year is certainly going to be the good period for the equity markets as such. You know, especially in the valuation front, you know, I mean, earnings growth expectation is very muted, and even now, And the FY13 earnings growth was also pretty much, you know, in weakest side, in only about 8 to 10% kind of an earnings growth you are seeing in FY10. And the weaker earnings growth, you know, next year also expectations are not really very high. See, if you look at earnings estimate for the Sensex for this financial year ending FY13 March, it's just around 1200 rupees per share. You know, if you look back, the earnings estimates about 2 years, 2 to 2.5 years back, earnings estimate for, you know, FY11 were as much as 1200 rupees a share. In the last 2 to 2.5 years, you know, the earnings have been downgraded so significantly that, you know, we are actually ending up at the Sensex EPS in this year, which was earlier estimated about somewhere in the FY11. So that kind of an earnings downgrades have already taken place. You know, we would see that, you know, from the current standpoint of actually there is a significant potential for earnings upgrades. You know, that will actually, you know, will probably take us into the, you know, the new highs for the next year as well.